So you've had your eyes examined and you've got your glasses prescription, which looks a little bit like this. But what happens if you've been told that you've got astigmatism and your prescription looks more like this? If you've never had astigmatism explained to you, or you're still confused, then in this video, I'm going to make sure that astigmatism is explained in a way that makes sense. Hi, I'm Martin Oguzie and this is Martin's Eye Tips. Thank you for joining me. On this channel, we're all about bringing you eye care tips, how-to videos and product reviews, all designed to help you see better, more comfortably and to be less anxious about your eyes. So if that sounds interesting to you, then please think about subscribing to the channel and also hit that notification bell so you get notified every time I release a new video. So let's get started with today's video, which is all about astigmatism. So in this video, in order for astigmatism to be explained, we're going to talk about three key areas. First of all, what is astigmatism? Secondly, how does astigmatism affect your vision? And thirdly, how we prescribe for astigmatism. So I want to start today with my peace of mind point. And that is to say that astigmatism is not a disease. And that's an important thing for you to be aware of, because often I see people, when they're first introduced to the term astigmatism, they're concerned whether it is a condition that has a sight-threatening implications, or whether it means that there's something more serious going on with their sight and with their vision. And in actual fact, it's a very common condition, and I'd go as far as to say that most people have some degree of astigmatism. It's in my experience more unusual to find somebody who has just a completely spherical eye and prescription with no astigmatism whatsoever. So it's definitely not a disease and definitely not something you have to panic about. So what is astigmatism? Now, to explain that, I'm going to be referring at points to a glasses prescription report. So if at any point you want to understand a bit more about how your glasses prescription works, then please refer to the link up there, and that will take you to a video that I made previously. Now, astigmatism is much like nearsightedness and farsightedness in that it's an error in the curvature of the front of your eye, the cornea, which means that the cornea, which is that first surface on your eye that you'd rest the contact lens on, it now has two different curvatures, a steeper curvature and a flatter curvature, compared to an eye that doesn't have astigmatism, where all the curvatures are of equal power. So rather than being spherical in shape like half of a beach ball might be, instead, because of this difference in curvature at the front of the eye on the cornea, then the eye has more of a shape like a rugby ball. And that's basically astigmatism explained in its simplest form. But the result of this difference in curvature in two directions is that your eye, instead of having one uniform focus point at the back of the eye, it now has two focus points at the back of the eye. Now, because in astigmatism we have these two different focus points, this is what causes the problems in vision that we associate with astigmatism. Now, it's also worth mentioning that you can get farsightedness and astigmatism in combination, as well as nearsightedness and astigmatism in combination, or you can get astigmatism on its own as well. So how does astigmatism affect your vision? Now, I've heard many people say that it can cause blurriness of your vision, but in actual fact, the key thing with astigmatism is that it causes distortion. And this distortion comes about because of these two focus points that you have, and the further away they are, the bigger your astigmatism is, and the more distorted things will look to you as well. So one of the key ways astigmatism affects your vision is that it distorts straight lines. And this can make text quite difficult to see. So if you're trying to read a number plate, or if you're doing intricate reading in bed, for example, then it could make it difficult to tell one letter from another based on where your astigmatism lines up with the lines on the letters. So this can cause that confusion between letters. So other than things just looking blurry, astigmatism can bring about distortion, which can make fine detail more difficult. So how do we prescribe lenses for astigmatism? So the best way to explain this is by having a look at a copy of somebody's prescription. So the eye with no astigmatism would only require one power that is the same in all directions on the curvature of the eye and the cornea. And that's why when you look at your prescription, you'd have a prescription that looks something like this, with simply one number in the sphere box. And that number then could be a plus or minus depending on whether you're far or nearsighted. the sill and the axis boxes would then remain empty. Now, the eye with astigmatism requires more information and more detail in order to achieve the right lenses to correct the vision and bring best clarity and sharpness. And that's why when we have a look at the prescription of somebody with astigmatism, we now require information in the sill box, which stands for cylinder, and the axis. And these two numbers go hand in hand. You can think of the cylinder number as a power or a strength of your astigmatism, whereas the axis is a measurement in degrees to inform us about where we want to put that curvature difference. So when we correct astigmatism, we need to add the additional power called the cylinder power or the sill on top of any sphere that we might have. Now, so we don't end up having a combined power of the sphere and the cylinder that is correcting equal strength in all directions and wouldn't actually deal with the curvature difference, we then need an axis. The cylinder has an axis, which is a direction along which there is zero cylinder power. So that when we combine the cylinder and the sphere, then along the zero power, only the power of the sphere comes through. That way, we've got a lens that now has the cylinder power in one direction only, and also the combination of whatever's in the cylinder and in the sphere in the other direction. And that's how we deal with astigmatism. Now, every eye is different, and as a result, where the axis needs to be on your eye is different. It's never always in the same place for everybody. So for some people, it may be at 90 degrees. Others, it may be along 180. And in fact, it could be any number between 0 and 180 degrees. Now, glasses aren't the only way to be able to correct astigmatism. Of course, you've also got the option of contact lenses, and we have specially made contact lenses that deal with the curvature differences on the eye as well. And these lenses are called toric contact lenses. So laser correction is also another option for people with astigmatism. So it doesn't rule you out like it used to back in the early days of laser. So in fact, you can actually get quite high levels of astigmatism corrected with a laser correction now. So I think powers up to about 6 diopters can be corrected. And that's pretty high given that most people will be comfortably under about 4. So that's essentially the key things that you should know about astigmatism. So for my tip of the day, if you're somebody who doesn't know whether you've got astigmatism, but you've got a copy of your prescription, then I suggest you pull that out and have a look at that prescription, because that will tell you whether you have astigmatism or not. So have a look for a number in the sill box and a number in the axis as well. So if you have numbers in those two boxes, then yes, you have astigmatism. If it's a small amount of astigmatism, it may be a 0.25, minus 0.25. Sometimes it can be plus as well. If it's a large amount of astigmatism, then it will be a number significantly higher than that. Today's question for you is, do you have astigmatism? And if you do, what strength is it? Leave me a message in the comment section below. Let me know what strength your astigmatism is. And that might be a number that is a -1, -2, -3, whatever it may be. Leave a message down there and I'll have a look at that. If you want to know more about your glasses prescription, then please check out my video over here. And if you want to find out more about whether you need glasses or not, then please have a look at the playlist listed over here as well. Until my next video, take care.